friends, this is Vedavati Varkala working in Narayana IAS Academy. We have started a new program called Prelims 2020 Made Easy. Now we are going to see types of different earthquakes. We have tectonic, volcanic, collapse, explosion and reservoir induced. I will explain this with the help of pictures to be easily understood. See, here is the tectonic earthquake, which means there is a fault that is happening and the blocks are moving in opposite direction. So this is happening on the plates only, on the surface of the earth. So this is tectonic. The second one is volcanic earthquake. This is also part of tectonic only because this is also happening almost on the surface. But this is happening because there is an explosion from inside and coming from the vent of the volcano. And because of this explosion, there are some minor tremors produced, and because of this tremors only, we are getting a feel of earthquake. So this is because of volcanic. Now this is collapse earthquake. Collapse means there are some huge buildings and structures that are collapsing because of the tremors. This happens mostly around the mining regions, where if there is intense mining activity that is happening, even the underground roofs of the mines, they collapse, causing great damage to the people. Now this is explosion earthquake. This is because imagine if there is a chemical device or a nuclear device and it exploded, and because of that there is some ground shaking happening around the surroundings, and that gives a feel of earthquake. And there is another one, reservoir induced earthquake, which happens in the area of structures of large reservoirs because there is some balance gone. That's why before building a reservoir, there should be an impact assessment, like how it is going to affect the region. Now we will see the measuring of earthquakes. It can be done by two scales, that is Richter scale and another is intensity scale. Now this scale measures the magnitude. The magnitude will be given from 0 to 10 points. Now that magnitude is nothing but the amount of energy that is released during the quake. So if the energy is more than 5 or 6 on the Richter scale, it means it is a very serious earthquake. The another one is named after Mercalli. He is an Italian seismologist, so who studied about earthquakes. Here we are taking into account of the magnitude and the energy, right? Here we will take into account the visible damage. So this is post phenomena. After the earthquake happens, they will see the damage of the property, the life, the structures, everything. And from that, the intensity is calculated and it is given in the range of 1 to 12. So remember, Richter scale is from 0 to 10 and intensity scale is from 1 to 12. Now let us see the effects of earthquakes. Those are ground shaking. Obviously, when such amount of energy is released, it violently shakes the ground, right? And that gives to the rise of fault between two rocks. Now there is differential ground settlement. Obviously, right, one block is moving this way, another block is moving this way. Now they are getting deformed, right? Land and landslide. See, the same thing again. It is the sliding of the land. And if there is a mountain or something, the land suddenly falls because of the shaking. And it damages whatever people or property on the ground level. And soil liquefaction happens. Nothing but the churning and mixing of the soil because of the movement of the land. Now there is ground lurching, which is nothing but to suddenly roll or pitch because of the sudden release of energy. And there is avalanches happening. See, in the region of Himalayas, there are many hills and mountains, right? And after some heavy rains, these become very liquid, kind. Now if there is a sudden movement or shaking around, a mass of debris, a huge mass of mud and rock, they suddenly fall down and it results in the death of the people. So these are avalanches, and that can happen because of earthquakes. And there is ground displacement as discussed, and there can be floods from dam and levee failures. There can be fires. There can be structural collapse of buildings and the property. There can be falling of objects, huge or small. And it can also result in the formation of a tsunami. See, if we see all the reasons up to 6, they all have bearings and landforms. It all directly deals with the lithosphere, land and the crust. But here, the rest of the reasons can have direct effect on life and properties of the people. So you can just remember this differentiation, which can affect people and the properties more and which can have effect only on land. Now let us have a small idea about tsunami. In the later classes, we will be discussing about this in very much detail. But for now, we have to know that tsunamis are caused by earthquakes, the main important reason. It can also be caused by volcanic eruptions, undersea landslides also. But the main reason is earthquakes. See, it happens when the epicenter of the tremor is below the ocean waters. What is the epicenter? The place on the surface where it experienced the waves, right, when we are talking about crust. But when we are talking about waters, if the epicenter is below the ocean waters, there the tremor is happening, it results in the formation of tsunami, and the magnitude should be sufficiently very high when compared to the magnitude that can happen on land. See, the tsunami is caused just not by the earthquake only, but after the quake happened, there will be some minor tremors and release of energy, right? And because of that tremors, the tsunami will be caused. See, in fact, the quake activity will be lasting only for a very few seconds. But if the magnitude is more than 5 on Richter scale, it can cause very much devastating effect, very some huge waves that can travel to very long distances. We studied, right, Richter scale, it is 0 to 10. So if it is more than 5, it results in tsunami. See, here is the earthquake epicenter. We discussed, right, it should happen under oceanic waters. Now when the energy is released in the form of waves like this, the wave starts moving from here. Here in the open ocean, you cannot tell if the tsunami is coming or not. It will be very peaceful. But as it is coming near the shore, the waves get huge and huge. And up to here, it will be almost up to 200 meters also. Now that is a tsunami wave. So there is one point to remember. As the wave is coming from epicenter to the shore, as it is coming near to the land, the wavelength decreases and the wave height increases. Now if the wave height increases, it is nothing but a tsunami wave. Now let us see some modal questions which came in different exams related to earthquakes. Epicenter is concerned with following: volcano, earthquake, landsliding and cyclone. It is very easy, nothing but earthquake. The point where it experiences the first earthquake waves. Just like we discussed now, it is the point on the surface directly above where the rupture along the fault zone occurs. So it is directly above the focus. Thank you.